Well, it was third time lucky. Finally, President Obama made it to Australia for a whirlwind two-day visit. He stopped off in Canberra first, laid a wreath at the Tomb of the Unknown Soldier. He also addressed Parliament and attended a function at Parliament House that night, tried out a few Aussie-isms while he was there. He decided ear bashing was one of his new favourite terms. Then he flew up to Darwin to visit another memorial, this time where US soldiers were killed in World War II, before flying off to Indonesia. Well, poor Kerri-Anne. Word this week the 40-year Channel 9 veteran had been dumped from her morning show in favour of new recruit Sonia Kruger. Execs had got her from Channel 7, she's the host of Dancing with the Stars, to host their new version of Big Brother. Part of the deal was that she got Kerri-Anne Kennelly's morning show as well. Well, if he were dead, we'd presume Kevin Foley would be turning in his grave right now. South Australia is on the verge of losing its AAA credit rating, but analysts are telling us not to panic just yet. That lack of revenue is more than made up for in infrastructure projects like Adelaide Oval, the new hospital, and the Southern Expressway. The old catchphrase, "Would you like fries with that?" has been replaced this week with "Would you like salad with that?" In order to keep up with Hungry Jack's and their new healthier choice options, McDonald's decided this week to try offer an alternative to the normal fries with your meal. You can now order a side salad. The PM has decided she's going to allow the issue of gay marriage go to her party for a conscience vote. But despite all the data showing a lot of support for same-sex couples to be allowed to tie the knot, Julia Gillard has announced that she will not be changing the Marriage Act anytime soon. Sad news for the cricket world this week with the death of commentator Peter Roebuck. He was over in South Africa commentating the Australia versus South Africa series when he was questioned by police over an alleged sexual assault of a young South African man. It's alleged that while one of the police officers was still in the room, Peter Roebuck jumped from the window of his six-story hotel. The case is being treated as a suicide. A 17-year-old mum and 19-year-old dad from Brooklyn Park were taken into custody when it was found their four-month-old baby was dead inside their unit and had been for a week. They've been charged with not telling authorities about the little one's passing. In court, the 19-year-old father broke down and cried so hard that the judge had to call a recess. An autopsy is being done to find out the cause of death.